of ANZ Championship Netball, everything goes on the line tonight in the fight for a grand final berth. The Northern Mystics have used their lifeline last week, and only a win will keep them in the running to go one better than last year. They say goodbye to retiring captain Temepata George this season, and they'll want to do their best to send her out in winning style. The Magic look to continue their momentum after a magnificent one-goal win over the Thunderbirds in the minor semi. They're hitting their best form of the season with a strong and committed defence and precision shooting. This is Sudden Death Netball. Which New Zealand side will earn the right to challenge the Vixens for the fifth ANZ Championship title? Find out live on your home of netball, Sky Sport.
Beating the Magic in Hamilton in the preliminary final. Now it is Waikato Bay of Plenty who have made the trip north in a bid to reach the ANZ Championship Grand Final for the third time. It is the biggest game of the season today. Star-studded teams, a packed house here at Trust Stadium, and it is all go. Good evening and welcome to this massive matchup. 60 minutes left for either the Mystics or the Magic to make their way into a Grand Final next weekend against the Melbourne Vixens. Anna Stanley, this is tough to pick. I've asked you already, how can you call it?
You can't. This is going to be a massive game. Both coming off very different games last week. The Mystics had a very comprehensive performance against the Vixens in the first half, but you'd have to say the second half they'd quickly want to forget. Magic, coming off a very good win against the Thunderbirds, were able to absorb the pressure. So tonight it's going to come down to who can play for 60 minutes, who can absorb the pressure.
So let's just double check those results from last weekend, the semi-finals and the final draw, what we have left. The Vixens beating the Mystics 56-50 in that major semi-final. The Vixens going straight through, the Mystics getting a life, of course. And then the minor semi-final, and what a thriller it was. The Magic beating the Adelaide Thunderbirds 49-48. So we have the Magic and the Mystics left now for a place in the grand final. They will be taking on the Melbourne Vixens. And Anna, what are those results from last week do to the mindset for these teams coming in tonight?
Well, I think you'd have to say the Magic will be coming in feeling pretty confident that they won that game against the Thunderbirds. But more importantly, that under pressure, they came up trumps. You know, we're not used to seeing Kiwi sides in the dying minutes of the game win it. They were down for most of it. So they'll come in with a huge amount of confidence. And the Mystics, they'll be wanting to play better than they did against the Mixons. That second half performance they won't be happy with. But this is their home turf. The Trust Stadium is their home. They'll have their fans, their family, and a lot of support here. They'll want to do it for them as well.
But there are a few that have made their way up from the Waikato as well. And of course, the Magic season has been an extraordinary tale. They couldn't buy a win at the start of the season. They've been on this enormous winning streak, coinciding perhaps with a settled lineup. My guess is Nolene Toto is not going to change too much tonight.
Absolutely not. Sticking with the seven that has been performing for her week in and week out, Irene van Dijk takes the goal shoot bib with Juliana Nauupu in at goal attack. Laura Langman has been in outstanding form. She takes the centre bib with KO Watts at wing attack, and Elias Shadrock in at wing defence. Doesn't get much more menacing than this. Casey Williams at goal defence and Liana De Bruyne at goal keep. Off the bench, we haven't seen much movement off the bench from Nolene. We could see a Tuki or a Waitapu only, I believe, if there are injuries. Let's now hear from the coach of the Magic, Nolene Tarua.
Well, Nolene, this is your fifth consecutive preliminary final. Have you taken your preparation any differently this time?
We kept to our same systems, routines and training times and days. The only thing that we've changed is we've actually tapered off. We've probably been happy where we've been able to do a lot of repetitious training. So instead of doing quantity, we've gone to quality.
Now, you would have seen the Mystics perhaps crack in that second half last week against the Vixens. Anything there that you can target?
Oh, you know, what's happened last week is totally last week, and where we're heading to, us and them, it's a whole new game, and you just got to bring it on the day.
Well, thanks, Nolene. We look forward to a great match.
Yeah, me too. Thank you.
The Silver Ferns captain, Casey Williams. Anna, how much of the Magic's revival, I suppose, has revolved around her return to fitness after surgery last year?
Oh, certainly a lot, I believe. Since that win in round four that the Magic had, it was Williams and De Bruyne back to their best. And since round four, they have just got better and better. And I think also it's the combination with Eli Shadrock on the outside that has helped. We saw last week Elias Shedrock got two crucial turnovers under pressure, so that was huge for her. She needs to step up again here tonight. She hasn't played much finals netball under pressure. She'll want to have a good one here tonight.
Oh, she's risen to the challenge so far, but can she do it again? The Magic lineup, of course, as we said, has stayed pretty much the same since round four, while the Mystics have been probably the one team in the competition that really mixed things up all season. What's Deb Fuller going with tonight?
Well, I think we're pretty safe to say that, yep, there we go. Catherine Latu gets the nod in at goal shoot with Maria Tutaia in at goal attack. Doesn't get much better than that as a shooting combination. In the midcourt, Jade Clark starts at centre with wing attack Temi Parra-George, and Charlotte Kite fills up the midcourt in at wing defence. Down the defensive end, Anna Harrison has recovered from her calf injury. She starts at goalkeep with the impressive Kayla Cullen in at goal defence. And off the bench, we have seen Deb Fuller use it. We could see Grace, Rachel Rasmussen or Jessica Moulds come on throughout the match. Let's now hear from the coach, Debbie Fuller.
Well, Debbie, what are some of the areas you've been working on since that game against the Vixens?
Just using ball speed on attack and defensively being able to work and connect together earlier.
And look, this is probably the first game for your team this year that they have faced sudden death, lose and you're gone. Does that make a difference?
Kind of, yeah. Well, it's do or die tonight. So, you know, if people want to be a big-time netballer, now's the time.
Well, the house is full. Make the most of it.
Thank you.
Well, it could very well be her last match tonight. If the Mystics lose, Temi Parra-George retires. Is that a factor for the Mystics in their build-up?
Oh, I think it'll be in the back of their minds. But, no, I think the focus will be on them wanting to win for themselves, for the Mystics franchise. And Temi Parra-George, what a sensational athlete she has been throughout her last decade playing at the top. She has been the stalwart of this team. She leads the team from the front. She's probably the best midfielder that's ever come out of New Zealand. And, she may have one more last game. She may have two. Who knows?
Well, another player, Catherine Latu, she is absolutely vital for them tonight too.
Yeah, one of the most accurate. Well, she is the most accurate shooter in this competition. Outstanding first half last week, but disappointing second half. So really important that she stays in the game. She's up against Williams and DeBrain, two of the most athletic defenders. She'll need to take her feet to the ball. She does have great hands. She's got great presence, a great hold. She'll need to use every bit of her strength to win that battle here tonight.
All right then, Anna, before we let you go, who wins it? Why? Say it again.
Magic by two.
Magic by two. The call comes from Anna Stanley. Will it be Temi Parra-George's final match in what has been an illustrious career? Will the Magic move on to fight another day? It is all about to go on the line. Mystics Magic, a place in the final at stake. Let's join our commentators, Jenny Woods and Catherine Harvey-Williams.
There has not been an ANZ Championship preliminary final without the Waikato Bay and Plenty Magic, and here they are again. In fact, this year's penultimate game in the competition features the same two teams as 12 months ago. The Magic versus the Northern Mystics. There's the Magic lineup. Catherine Harvey-Williams, a very tried and true combination.
Yeah, it's a very experienced one with a little bit of inexperience in the midcourt, but a team that's certainly in form. They've come into this preliminary final in a different way to previous years, so maybe that will be the point of difference for this Magic side, but they're certainly coming in with a load of confidence.
They have. They have known for the last, 10 rounds that if they drop a game, they were goners. And here they still are. But this is what the Magic Rounder are up against. Not only these seven players, but also this massive crowd at the Trust Stadium Arena. And again, Deb Fuller sticking with the tried and true.
Yes, they've certainly got a settled starting seven, and they have been known to make changes at halftime or during the course of a game. These players will be feeling the pressure. There'll be a lot of adrenaline pumping through the veins, but this is what you play for, Jenny. It's so far to the grand final, yet they can be so close. Only time will tell which team will represent New Zealand in the grand final next week.
And I tell you what, it's been fascinating walking around the stadium ahead of this game. The tension in the crowd is palpable, and there's a very big contingent from further south. They're here to watch the Magic. Game on in the preliminary final 2012. Magic versus Mystics. Temi Parra-George straight into the thick of the action.
As a player, he's certainly keen to get your hands on the ball nice and early, slot an early goal or get an early intercept just like Kite. did on that occasion. So something for the home side to cheer about early. Sharon Kelly, the umpire on screen. Of course, one Australian umpire, one New Zealand umpire in the playoffs. And here's the work of Kite. It was pretty easy pickings.
Nervous pass that was.
Patience from the Mystics. Players just feeling their way at the moment. Had a great deal of intensity out there. A brilliant tip to Williams.
Offside the call. So lucky pick up for the Magic.
But it was preceded by defensive work. Largely tipping that out of court. So the Magic will start again.
Now we'll give them a few minutes to settle into the game. There's so much pressure on these players. And as experienced as you are, never changes.
Marupu having to go back to Watts. McCullum fancying the chances. Now they find it. And as you can see, there's a good chunk of Waikato Bay of Plenty colours in that crowd.
Mystics will need to look out for that combination. Langdon to Van Dijk. It was quite potent last week.
Quick hands from McCullum. Bit of contact as she went through. Nauka, one of the players last week, Catherine, really stood up for the Magic.
Yeah, she's certainly earning her stripes. She sat on the bench for a number of years, but now she's a starting player for the Magic and just enjoying the responsibility.
That was a marvellous feed. Thumbs up from Latu.
Oh, a chop around the neck to Langman. Goes the Mystics' way.
What a task for Elias Shadrock tonight, marking Tingapata George. The Mystics with the advantage. Whiskey ball. George sort of gives Latu the smile. Yep, my bad.
Langman being given a lot of space. Big play from Naupu, driving to front position, drawing a defender, so it leaves Van Dijk open one-on-one. People talk about Tutaia looking relaxed on the shot. I think Naupu's claimed that mantle almost. Van Dijk coming out of the circle a lot. Harrison happy for her to do that.
George getting the arm across Williams. Ball as she does so. You hear the call from Watts on the side of the goal circle. The centre pass. Well, Latu did her best to keep that alive. That was loose from Clark. And you could be mistaken for thinking that's a Mystics chant, given that we're in Auckland, but in fact it's a Magic chant. And that's the reason why. And it's interesting, isn't it, Catherine? You look at the stats from these two teams' history.
They've played each other five times here at the stadium in Waitakere, and the Magic have won every time.
Yes, it's hard to believe, but you've also got to remember that just a couple of years ago, the Mystics weren't much of a competitor. In the past couple of years, they have changed their culture, and they certainly are a force.
Kite flying through on Langman. Yes, a little bit of footwork there.
Their game plan's pretty obvious though. Jenny, look for Naupu driving into the circle. Two on one in the circle, covering Latu. Oh, made to work for that one, and that was just exquisite. Terrific skills.
I don't know how she managed to hold onto that ball and stay in court.
Precision pass too.
No one in the circle. Now Tutaier rackets in.
Good drive from Tutaier, forcing Williams to put out the arm to stop her. That's all you can do sometimes.
Mystics grab the last two goals.
Langman just given a little bit too much freedom at the moment.
Harrison beautifully high. Not a shot missed by either side so far. They'll have to come back because that centre pass has gone the wrong way. Now we're right. Blatt again going high.
Good defence from the Magic, forcing those Mystics players into the pockets. It's her spot.
Fabulous shooting. Tutaier.
You'd almost prefer to push Tutaier under the post. More chance of her missing from that distance.
Steve Price will have enjoyed that. He's a regular here in Waitakere. And don't forget, Facebook. Get on board, like us, have your say. And the call goes against Langman.
That was brilliant defence by the Mystics. They lined up at the top of the circle. There was nowhere for the Magic to go. Bad shooting in a pressure situation.
Absolutely outstanding. Halfway mark, first quarter.
Oh, right on her game, Williams. Terrific footwork, light on her feet. That's what you want to see in a defender.
Court, out of court, so it's a throw in to the Mystics. They're on a three-goal run.
That's persistent from George. Sometimes players get an advantage by breaking from the back, but Sharon Kelly was onto that. Really good contest between Williams and Tutaier at the moment.
There's so much of this game like a New Zealand trial. Waimarama Tamanu in the crowd.
Oh, I'd be pretty surprised if that girl doesn't make the Silver Ferns team. She's had some outstanding games this year.
That is offside when defence.
Big defence from Devane.
Been watching her counterpart down the other end. That's a Harrison specialty.
All the way from the Mystics.
Vantage contact, all attack.
with her trademark attack of the ball.
Yeah, brilliant work, Van Dijk. Caught on the baseline, just popped out. She's really added that dimension to her game this year. That held there, back on court, opens up.
Cullen still going in the other direction. Did well to stay onside. She did that right in front of a huge pocket of Magic fans. So now, a swing the way of the Magic. Nice tip from Shadrock. Just slows the progress of the Mystics.
On fire. Can she sustain it though? That's always the question with Tutaia. Such a key to this Mystic side. Again, Nopi driving.
That time, Harrison's clean. Big jump.
Brilliant work, Shadrock, continuing on from last week.
She was interesting last week, Shadrock. Quiet in the early stages of the game. How's that for a take?
Been watching Shadrock, brilliant take here, but Shadrock, just that couple of key intercepts last week against the Thunderbirds, has seen her start here tonight, a different player, just full of confidence.
Talk about confidence. 10 all, just over 2.5 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
Oh, good effort, Harrison. Oh, pressure all round from the Mystics, well deserved.
Brilliance.
One of the best players in the competition this year, Langman.
Yeah, it's gutsy play from the Magic. Watts did well to get her hands away. This first quarter has flown past.
Shadrock making George earn every ball.
Oh, brilliant. Straight through the middle, Van Dijk. Setting the penalty. Into the final minute. Williams went hunting. Now she's back.
Banning swing contact.
Oh, Latu opened up the last minute.
Just 3 goals from Latu in this quarter. Contact. 8 for Tutaia. Make that 9. Former Silver Fern defensive duo, Vilimaina Davu and Linda Wagner. And they have interesting thoughts on this game, I'm sure. So the Magic will want to get this in. Mystics doing a good job of slowing everything down. Now it's advanced.
Final, all tied up, 12 all. you know where the Pirates...
Debbie Fuller, pleased with her defensive unit and very much pleased with Maria Tutaia.
Yes, both defensive units putting in a decent effort so far. Casey Williams will want to tighten up a little bit on Tutaia. She's getting some tips, but Tutaia doing all the damage in that shooting circle. Pretty even across the board. Penalties in favour of the Mystics, but nothing to be concerned about at this stage. But we have got a game on our hands, and it's exactly what we expected.
So, Seb... second quarter on its way. It'll be the Mystics with the first set of pass. It is 12 all. Mystics away at the top of the second quarter. Nothing in this game. 12 goals apiece. Kayla Cullen does well just to keep a footing. Pressure coming here from the Magic. That time, Tutaia offloading. And that's just Lati's fourth goal of the match.
It's a good strategy, though, for Tutaia to offload so they don't expect her to go to the post all the time. Latu's creating some play, though. She's bringing Tutaia into the game, so I wouldn't be concerned about her lack of shooting at this point in time. Tutaia is the hot shooter.
Advantage obstruction wing. Advantage contact and offside. Wing attack. Advantage causing centre.
Jade Clark right on Langman. Quick work, the call against Timmy Potter George. A little opening here for the Magic.
Good vision from Shadrock. Went over the miss.
As did that.
And now we're getting the better of Cullen at the moment.
Langman waits. No, who delivers? Catherine, they seem to have superb faith, don't they? Sometimes the Magic, you know, they run so close to 3 seconds, but they know that player is going to come free.
And you've got to give credit to their shooters. And Van Dijk, the different dimensions she's added to her game this season is absolutely phenomenal. When you've been around the traps for so long, tonight she's in outstanding form.
Latu had the hand up. Shadrock bats it away.
She's a different player. Amazing what a bit of confidence does.
Landon very eager to get a hands on that ball for that centre pass. They're playing at pace.
Langman's second, third effort, so good.
Wide applause for herself from Juliana Naupi. Not sure who that was meant for, but you weren't going to fool De Bruijn. Great pressure from the Mystics, pushing Magic over to the sideline.
Oh.
Great start to the second quarter from the Magic.
That is great.
And you can hear the cowbells. I had heard that the cowbells had been confiscated when the Magic supporters entered the stadium, but they've obviously got them back.
Been very patient with their delivery, the Magic, and it's working for them.
Incredible shot from Naoko. And we've got a timeout, and I guess that might come as no surprise.
It is Jade Clark who has called the timeout. Jenny, she's getting some work on her left calf, but as you say, probably comes as no surprise. The Magic really just upping that intensity and that pace, aren't they, to start this second quarter?
Yeah, suddenly it's a four-goal margin. Let's see if we can pick up what Deb Fuller has to say.
Keep them away. They're hanging on the roll, you and Nick Harding. That's all. It's just your own.
And the ball's on this side.
The calmest address I've ever heard in my life. But you don't want your coach to panic. You want them to be calm and in control.
Well, let's see if it does the job. 18-14, the Magic lead early in the second quarter.
Well, you wonder what goes through Deb Fuller's mind. She's got so many options on the bench that she has used during the course of the season.
Boy, late from Shadrock. Can you have too many options?
It just creates a lot of headaches. You could argue yes, but it's always nice to have options. But if you don't, you certainly have less headaches in that respect. But I guess you worry about other things then.
Mystics close it to a lead of three. Harrison called.
The crowd are going absolutely berserk.
I beg your pardon, it's Van Dyke called. Putting the ball into Harrison's hands.
Oh, strong take, Clark, coming to the ball.
Oh, lucky Tute, yeah, you can see the smile on her face.
When things are going your way, they're going your way.
That's right up. And into her hand, so the Mystics strike back.
And I think Latu wishes she went to the post then. She was close enough.
Oh, the brain. She is fast.
It's unlucky, I feel.
Terrific balance from Watts.
Yeah, what a story she's been, Kale. Watts is playing State League in Adelaide, not wanted by the Thunderbirds, and here she is.
Cullen comes to help from the back.
Oh, gutsy pass, and how's that for skill? That wasn't lucky, she knew what she was doing.
Well, you can see, look at this.
That's just brilliant.
Thank you.
whichever team wins this game is going to have to produce something really special. Face tells it all. Well, some you win, some you don't. Williams looking at the umpire. Take a look at this. It was a hoist sort of gone wrong, and then it went so right for the Magic. This game's got it all. Tutaya and Latu saying during the week that they had some little tricks up their sleeves. Now the call against one of the shooters. Golding was the call from Sharon Kelly. It's in fact against KO Watts on the edge of the circle. Couple of big calls down there going the Mystics way. Oh, Watts gets it back. And that's unfortunate for Dean to come off the foot of Timmy Putter-George. But that's twice now. When the Magic have lost possession, they have won it straight back. Oh, again, Harrison.
Van Dyke needs to come into play there.
Yeah, she's making life very difficult for Noupu. So much taller, Anna Harrison. That's outstanding from the Mystics. 20 all, just under 6 minutes remaining in this half.
Yeah, the 1-2 to Tutaya is very dangerous at the moment.
The brain hits the deck, but she won't care. She's got the ball.
That is intimidation win.
Shadlock just wants the ball. Helen knows what she's doing, though.
Terrific pressure from the Mystics defence.
That is contact obstruction with defence.
Langman looked one way, had to go the other.
Oh. Some great clashes out there.
Jade Clark giving a little nod, sort of, yep, I know I was offside and contacting. Busloads of those fans headed north tonight. Latu coming out to do her bit.
Yeah, that's what you do when your partner's on song. Create the play for them and position yourself for the rebound. Brilliant work.
Oh, lucky for Williams. Oh, Jade Clark nearly through.
Yeah, there's no easy ball out there. Everyone is putting in an attack and defence.
Well done, Anna Harrison. Wins the battle for the rebound.
She's certainly providing her team with their fair share of opportunities.
Oh,
a tangle down the court. Not short from Tutaier. Magic let off the hop.
Double Latu scoring rate at the moment. Tutaier 14, Latu 7.
Again, another chance for the Mystics. Out the back. Oh, unfortunate for the Mystics. They've actually got themselves into a better position. Tutaier makes good with that shot.
Clark needs to come in. She's sitting wide. Almost held ball.
Yes, I think Shadrock had expected Langman to come back.
Everyone went left. And Van Dijk just stayed put.
Lovely work, George brought Tutaier into it. Devane over the top. Right back at you, Anna Harrison.
She had no option there, she was fully committed.
Discussion of exactly just where the penalty was to be taken. Few extra centimetres that De Bruyne has over Latu.
Not set.
What did we talk about before? The setting of the penalty. So a late chance for the Mystics to draw level. Goal pressure, De Bruyne.
Gee. Tied out there.
A very physical few moments. Tora on her feet. The clock ticking down to half time. And there is the whistle for the end of the first half of this preliminary final. It's a blinder. It's the Magic leading the Mystics 24-23. Absolutely nothing in the, it was level at quarter time. One goal in it. Let's go sideline.
Well, Catherine Latu, it was a breathless first half. What's it like down there for you in that shooting end?
We always knew it was going to be really tough, and it is really tough, but it's not over yet.
What do you need to do in the second half to get in and get into the final?
We need to look after the ball. We're not going to win without it.
Stuff, good luck for it. Thank you.
Simple message from Catherine Latu. We'll just have to wait and see if they can do that in the second half, because it is halftime, and it is 24-23, the Magic over the Mystics.
Welcome back to Trust Stadium. Halftime, and it is the Magic leading the Mystics 24-23. And I've got a very eager-eyed guest with me, the Melbourne Vixens coach, Julie Hornweg. Your team waiting for the winner. What did you make of that first half?
Oh, wow, what an exciting half of netball. What a goal for goal just about the whole time. So, pretty really hard to predict who might win, so we'll have to keep watching very carefully in the second half.
What do you see as the key factor out there at the moment that you might be picking up a few tips?
Oh, we're just watching some of the work off the ball, just seeing perhaps where they start, where they finish, what's happening to get themselves clear of the ball. But, yeah, just looking for that extra little 1% that might make the difference next week.
Well, your team gets the weekend off, I suppose, this week, but how have your preparations been so far and what's ahead for the week?
We've been trying to keep it as normal as possible. We've been doing our court work and our gym work and our session as we would normally do. It's just that they got the 2 days off over the weekend, which is fantastic, really, at this time of the year.
Well, good luck for the final. We better let them get back into it. Can I grab a quick prediction off you, though?
OK, too tight to tell. We don't mind. Whoever comes out to play, we'll be really happy to meet.
Good luck for the final next week. Thanks for your time, Julie.
Thank you.
Well, the championship this year has been a bit like a good book. You want to know what happens, but you don't want it to end. But for one of these teams, they have just 30 minutes of netball left. Catherine Harvey-Williams, we all know what this third quarter is all about.
It is the premiership quarter, but you just get feeling, Jenny, it's the fine line between pleasure and pain. These teams are so even. The statistics show it. Defensively, it's such a great effort by both sides. 12-11 in that second quarter. So what it tells us is the team that can up the ante in attack will be the team that comes away with this one.
Naupu looking very relaxed. These two, will they play each other day in, day out? Second half underway. Magic leading the Mystics by one, 24-23.
Interesting to see no changes to the Mystics, a side that has rung the changes all year and stuck with their starting seven.
The call against Jade Clark. So early turnover for Magic. Let's go sideline now to speak with Mystics coach Debbie Fuller just as a turnover goes the side of way of her team. Debbie, where do you want the improvement in this half?
I just want us to be able to mix it up on attack. We got a little bit predictable in that last quarter, so we've got to keep Liana and Casey figuring out what they have to defend.
You alluded to it there, Debbie, that Maria's doing the bulk of the shooting. Are you wanting Latu to come into the game more or let her?
Well, she's been a good draw because they're dropping back and letting Maria shoot. So, but we've got to mix it up. We can't have Maria shooting the whole game. Kat will come into it.
Thanks, Debbie.
Thank you.
So another miss for Van Dyke, but she was all on her own to put away the rebound.
Contact, goal attack.
Watts waits for Naupu to just come round. A sweet shot from Juliana Naupu, nothing but net. Two pickups for De Bruyne, although just a deflection on that occasion. Let's now hear from her coach, Nolene Tohua. Nolene, is Tutahia the big danger for you?
I think all of them at the moment. Obviously, you've got to be able to get the ball for her to be able to shoot, and they're doing it quite nicely, so.
And Naupu, Nolene, she's getting lots of ball in the circle, but her shooting stats falling away. Have you asked her to offload or just keep going to the post?
She's got to be very smart, and this is a trying time for her. She knows what her sweet spots are, so it's up to her once again to be quite smart about what she's doing.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Magic having a real battle to get the ball into the circle.
Is that a sweet spot? We're about to find out.
It's an all over the top spot. Is the call. Magic living dangerously here.
There's nothing between these two sides. Fierce competition.
No, that spot is definitely not sweet. Nice drive by Cullen through the court.
Spinning the circle, De Bruyne and Williams.
Awkward for Clark. So quite a number of turnovers. Look at this battle for the ball. The Oscar goes to...
Advantage obstruction! Advantage contact! Advantage obstruction! Advantage obstruction, centre!
Mangum doing all her feeding from here to the circle. Callum Quick. Difference between those contact calls, 40 against the Mystics, 20 for the Magic. I must say, the Magic defenders have been relatively clean all season.
You look at that stat, actually surprises me. It doesn't feel like that when you're watching the game. It doesn't feel like a 2-1 clash.
Great grab of the ball by Latu.
Sometimes you can read too much into statistics. Now again, Langman, that's a dangerous spot. And as a defender, there's just nothing Harrison and Cohen can do when Langman's positioned herself there. So those mid-court defenders need to stop her from getting on the edge of the circle.
Third quarter, 28-25, the Magic in front. But really, there is nothing in it. Acres of room for Latu on the baseline
to roll at its very best. Good timing.
Gets her rhythm back.
Contact. Come on, stepping.
The brain just unable to stop the flow of that ball. Nice turn from Watts. Good draw now, Opu. Last opportunity. Timmy Parra George will know it. Oh, and that, look at Casey Williams in the background thinking, what was I thinking?
Williams and George making two big errors. Very uncharacteristic.
That was loose from Williams.
Yeah, you wouldn't feel too good about yourself after that.
Oh, good pressure from Carmen. Just took a tip and off the Magic player. One side of the court to the other.
It's just about finding the gaps. The defense is so good.
Shadrock getting right under George, which is no mean feat.
Oh, this is a terrific game.
Here it goes. Not letting go of that ball. So chance here for the Mystics to draw level. Oh, not past Latu. So the Mystics use a little bit of magic of their own.
Joy to watch, Captain Latu.
And here we go. Injury break, I think, called by the Magic.
Liana De Bruin has called the injury timeout, just getting some ice up on the right shoulder. Looks, doesn't... to see her go off for the magic.
She just bounced off Latu earlier, so I think it was a bit of a sting and a bit of a time to regroup. Ball's now being leveled. Mystics on a bit of a surge, last three goals. Tell you what, it's party time in the stadium. Clear message from the skipper, Langman. The ball's in your vicinity, pull it in. This game locked up, 30 goals all. Halfway mark, third quarter, big tip.
Oh, over the top, Callan pulled for contact. Tight one.
Tutaia on the side of the court. Now they come across the Mystics.
This defence from both sides is extraordinary. There haven't been too many flows from attack right into the shooting circle, from defence into the shooting circle. It's because it's been relentless.
And that offload working nicely for the Mystics now. Was so close to Hal Bork. Jade Clark rather hoping that was going to go her way. Tutaia had a bit of a look in, wondered about it.
Contacting defense, advantage offside. That's it. Know where you are.
Now Watts needs to offer and re-offer. She's letting Langman do all the work. Magic really battling. When you think the battles that these two players have fought together.
Excellent defense by the Mystics. They want to break the magic here. Tutaia told that that's enough.
And there's the call they were after. Hell ball. Could this be a turning point? Charlotte Pike hits the deck heavily. She's up again. I don't think you'll see any players bowing out of this game. Excellent work by George. A fabulous lean from Williams, but there's the offload. Mystics back in front, centre pass to come. That's what Fuller was talking about, just share the load, mix it up a bit, keep the defenders guessing. Timmy Parra-George does not want to end her career tonight. Oh, Langman read that one. Unfortunate for the Magic. Big
cross court. Watts on the charge. One of the few times there's been an opening through the midcourt. Now it's the turn of the Magic to use the little offload to Van Dyke. Callum called, so opportunity for 2-on-1 in the circle. Wow.
Oh, not good enough from Watts.
And that's opportunity blown contact, by the Magic.
You just get a feeling it's those little things that are going to make the difference. It's so tight.
Into the final attack. 2 minutes of the third quarter, 33 all.
That is contact, wing defense, and offside. Contact centre. Outside the circle.
That one's good from Judea.
Yeah, well read Harrison, but it was never on.
I'll tell you what, Catherine, I bet Julie Hornwig is enjoying this game, seeing how hard these two games, the two teams are going at each other, thinking they'll be tired next week. That's great work from the Mystics.
Just seizing up a little bit here, the Magic. That's because the defenders of the Mystics are really up the ante. And there they are, a very special group of Magic supporters, those men. Yeah, the husbands and boyfriends, the Habs.
To be quick here, the Magic. They're going backwards at the moment.
Yeah. That's a charge from Tito, yeah.
An experience from Shadrock, she needs to get on with it. Langan will go long.
Wasted opportunity there. And the crowd knows all about it. They knew that the time was ticking. High fives from the Mystics players at the end of the third quarter. It's the Mystics in charge, 36-34. Trophy just 15 minutes remaining in the preliminary final. It's the Northern Mystics ahead, 36-34.
Yeah, good shooting percentage from the Mystics under all sorts of pressure. Catherine Latu certainly came into the game in that third quarter. It's all about distributing the load.
Final quarter of the preliminary final, 36-34. Mystics lead.
This is it, all right. This is what you play for, an opportunity.
to match it with the best next week.
And you wonder, Kath, if Deb Fuller was just smelling blood a little bit, saying we've got the hesitation, now we want the turnover.
It was very evident that the Magic certainly lost their way a little bit toward the end of that quarter. It was the Magic of old, hesitant to put the ball in. But like Tarua said, just keep coming to the ball. Offer, re-offer.
Contact with the fence, of course.
Van Dijk won't want it out there.
And it's offside, centre.
Now she's over there. Big opportunity for the Mystics.
Yeah, the momentum certainly swung. They followed Fuller's instruction. Latu come into the game more, so therefore the defenders had to concentrate not just on Tutaia, but the goal shoot as well.
Instruction, the call. From De Bruyne. A ball has a mind of its own. It's probably sick of being thrown all over the court. The ball is good.
With all the technology available, we've still got the net.
A big chance here for the Mystics to push the lead to 5.
Well, Tengapara George, she's been one of the instigators of this surge by the Mystics. Really getting on top of Shadrock now.
This Auckland crowd starting to rise to their side. 39-34. The Magic are going to have to pull something out of the bag.
Yeah, good vision from Langdon. Harrison went hunting.
Contact centre after their first. Yep.
Oh. On the arm, the call from Sharon Kelly. Well, that stops the rock for the Magic. Their first goal of this final quarter.
Always in a contest of rain. But the defence of this Mystic side is solid. There's just no easy way through.
And that's a great tip. No, it's ball's gone against Clark. It was hard luck because it was good work from Jade Clark.
That is obstruction.
Again, the feed hit. Langdon not keen to get it in.
That is contact centre. Contact goalkeeper. Contact.
Yeah, look for the offloads. They're coming on a regular basis from now to now.
And that's a big miss from the Magic.
Yep, we call that a stuff up.
And there's one from the Mystics. So things going a little wobbly for both sides here in the final quarter.
Vantage offside centre.
Harrison really getting her hand to a lot of ball now. It's hard to keep up with this game.
Oh, just a little kick from Harrison. Is that a volleyball move? What's the right foot?
That's why she doesn't play soccer.
Height on the charge. Oh, that was awkward for no input from Thun. They're just challenging everything in Mystics and forcing errors. That was nearly sailing west. Tukayet not bothering to look in. Set a pass to come for the Mystics. So they're holding on to this buffer. As that ball's retrieved. And again, Magic under all kinds of pressure.
Contact, goal attack.
And Tito, yeah, she's come to play tonight. An interesting captain in this game, Fuller deciding to make no changes. Last few games, we've seen quite a raft of changes.
Yeah, it's fascinating, isn't it? That I think when the time comes, you just want the players that you think are the best ones out there to remain there and do the job. I think they've noticed that sometimes change causes disruption. Oh, look at the defense of this Mystic side. It's impenetrable.
Magic do not want to put this ball in until then.
That's what they need to do, just keep giving the ball. They've lost a bit of confidence now, but time's not on their side.
I think they need a little bit of inspiration. And in the past, it's so often come from these back two, De Bruyne or Williams. And they do it tonight.
Just look at George. She wants to play another week.
Well, she's probably had about 5 million quarters of netball. She wants some more.
Shadrock's specialty. Pulled them out of the hat last week. Can she do it again?
She ducks under the arms of Catherine Latu.
Goalkeeper obstruction.
Here's an opportunity. Harrison out.
Outside the circle.
They desperately need this, the Magic.
Obstruction, goalkeeper.
They mucked up the last one. Everyone's standing still. Extraordinary pressure.
Oh, Langan just doesn't want to give it. Such is the pressure.
No, to very.
Oh, how do you do that against Van Dijk?
Oh, smashed and blow. Fans on their feet. It's certainly physical.
This is the final. What do they expect?
Set the penalty. Set. Yep.
Too scared to move now, I think. Yeah, she was going for the ball.
The defence on these two attackers. Harrison is giving it everything. What a competitor.
And that would have been the longest shot that Irene van Dijk's attempted for a while. I don't think they should go. She's been outstanding, Harrison. So, Magic, a little bit of a comeback, but they need to get closer. Mystics will want to put the foot down.
Oh, the net.
Just over 5 minutes remaining. 42-39. The Mystics in front.
Vantage contact.
Vantage they want side. Another crack at the Melbourne Vixens. Oh, Langman had gone back. Just as Nauta became available.
The circle defence from Cullen and Harrison is as good as you'll see.
Taking a cautious approach. And they'll know that all they have to do is keep control of their own ball.
Good earlier, start throwing it around. The more passes you have, the more chance the opposition has to get it.
So you wouldn't employ Malawi tactics right now.
A bit early.
Into those safe hands of Tutaia. And taking Van Dijk right out of play. Now on the ground, Van Dijk.
Made to work for everything, Van Dijk. But she's certainly up for it. She just gives and gives.
Two goals in it.
They're just holding firm, aren't they?
They are. And the Magic need something big. They did it last week against the Thunderbirds. Can they do it here in Auckland?
Shadrock off the head.
There's one. There's the push.
Oh, an extra time. Has been a terrific match from start.
De Bruyne takes a huge breath before letting that pass go. They cannot afford a mistake. The Mystics will be wanting to slow everything down.
So remember what the Magic did to the Thunderbirds last week. Came from nowhere to snatch it.
Contact's called.
She's been strong in the hands because Harrison has given it everything.
These fans look incredulous at what they're seeing. There's one goal in it. It is the Magic centre pass.
Charlotte Pike calling time.
What a time to call time. Ricky Swissnell, that has to be gamesmanship.
You would have to think so, Jenny. We were just about to get ready to move to get to the end of the match, and what looks like Charlotte Kite has called the time. She's going to get a little bit of work done on her ankle, but let's listen in.
Championship.
That's the situation.
Hero and heroes and villains. What's going to happen here?
One mistake and the dream is over.
Big shot. Oh.
The cowbell. bells are ringing, the banners are banging. No one wants to make an error. Casey Williams pulled up short, done something to her foot. Into the final minute, the Magic trail by one goal. He's going to play it around now, the Mystics. The Magic need to man up. Oh, De Bruyne! Bit of shot of her career now, Upu. Steady as ever, we are into extra time. And there is treatment for Casey Williams. Well, I was going to talk about extra time a few moments ago, and then I thought, no, here it is. Here's a little Liana De Bruyne. She has saved the day for the Magic. What a brilliant player. Latu waving her arms, screaming with disappointment. Lucky break there for the Magic. And now Uvu can't believe it. Van Dijk has saved the day for her. So just to remind you, because it is a long time since we've had extra time, there will be two extra periods, each of 7 minutes. And, of course, if it's still tied up after that time, then we go to that heart-rending time where you have to play until a two-minute goal advantage. The stats in that quarter there, Jenny, 10-8 with such quality attacking players. It just goes to show what a defensive game this is.
You know what, Jay, particularly when they can't run, when there's a ball here and they can't run here, all they do is coming up for a square here. We go this one here. You run it hard.
In this break between ordinary time and extra time, you can see she's got the boot off.
And she obviously twisted her foot when she came down. She was in quite a bit of pain at the time.
There it is. Came down off the foot of De Bruyne. So, oh my word. She gets a pat on the back, go get him. But she certainly does appear to be favouring that foot. Teme Parra-George, she wants more. She might not have wanted this much more. So first extra time period of 7 minutes. Extra time underway, 44-all.
The goal attacks really fell away in that quarter. Jenny, two to Taya, just two from two.
Well, the goal shooters keep on their merry way, and now we're through 2 from 7. She really needs to up the ante in terms of her percentage.
Okay, yes, sizes up her options. From George.
Sometimes too, when you go into this extra time, Jenny, the team that thought they had the game in the bag fall away. See what happens here with the Mystics.
And Shedrock not wanting to risk anything. The brain picks herself up. Oh, good work from Jade Parks. Slowing progress. And whoever does win this game, not quite a full week before they have to face the grand final. Harrison again, but too close.
Yeah, the Fixins will be watching this game, thinking they can play for as long as they like. Watts has come into the game a little bit more. I thought she was tiring earlier.
That's the tight. Makes the shortcut round the back of the post. So look at that swing to the Magic. Last 4 goals.
Yeah, they were almost home, the Mystics.
Wow. And you could see Tutaia took a long time with that shot.
Tell you what, the old bookends for the Magic have really stood up in this game. An average age of 37 and a half.
Yeah, Jade Park pushing off. Liana De Bruyne had a birthday last week. But said at the time, not time for celebrations yet.
Langman just, every centre should watch her game. Never gives up.
Confidence levels have risen for the Magic. Centre pass to come.
So important, Langman. When she stopped giving the ball, the Magic struggled. But she's freed herself up now. Happy to let the ball go.
Long time to go in this game. Late from Kite. Mystics desperately need a goal here. That's just what they didn't need. Now a mistake going the other way. So the Mystics get out of jail on that one. Clark. Great guard from Williams. Yeah, Tutaia not wanting the shot.
There was a contact there, but I think away they go.
Everyone waited, but no call. So could that be another little turning point in this game? There's been so many. The first goal the Mystics have scored in extra time. G
She's in a lot of pain, Casey Williams, but we know that she'll play her heart out.
It's a worry for them, though. Even if they do get to go through, there's not going to be a lot of time for repair work. Look at Van Dijk and Harrison.
She has landed some big ones in extra time. Now, if we lost her way in that last quarter, come good again.
Oh, De Bruyne thought about it. The arm from Latu. At the end of this period of 7 minutes, they change straight over. No rest.
Oh, reprieve there for the Mystics. Contact De Bruyne.
And where the shooter is. That's it.
Pullock looking a bit concerned.
I want to hold this up now, the Mystics. Oh, unlucky. I think that's been about, no, what's the... Another big shot. I'd give it to Van Dijk.
They want to be quick, the Mystics. There'll be time to get the ball away. They need to score. Oh, it's a break. And that is the end of the first 7 minutes. It was all magic. How is that for a momentum shift?
2-7, and they lost the opportunity of that centre pass. Just the little things now, the magic, getting a sniff.
So the Mystics have gone into a little bit of a huddle.
Some changes.
There's a change coming, Jenny. A huge call to make by Debbie Fuller. Jessica Moulds is coming on at goal keep, and Harrison is going to move to goal defence. And it looks as if Kayla Cullen will get to the bench, so Charlotte Kite stays on at wing defence.
So tell me, Catherine, you're Jess Moulds. How do you feel coming into this cauldron?
Yeah, I felt for her against the Vixens. Came on in the last quarter. There wasn't much she could do. But look, this is what you throw on. No one's expecting much. They look gone for all money, the Mystics, so Moulds could make a difference. They had to do something.
7 minutes remaining in this extra time period.
Just wonder if the Mystics should have done more. 5 goals down. Had to throw caution to the wind.
Shadrock could smell it.
She is giving it everything on the shot, Williams. She can hardly walk. Not great signs for next week, but they'll worry about that later.
Duteye doesn't miss the second opportunity. Van Dijk getting front position. A high shot from Naruto. A little smile and then the applause. And George doing well to take that in the midcourt. How fitting that this last home game for Temapara George should go to extra time.
Yes, we should enjoy George's performance out there because we're not sure if it'll last another week now. Things are getting tight for the Mystics. But what a brilliant player she's been.
But they've got time, the Mystics. They've seen the magic fight their way back.
They certainly do, Jenny. Just a couple of turnovers, that's all it takes. It's not always easy when you're in front.
you do start to tighten up like they're doing now. Yes, they're playing around with it, but the Mystics are getting opportunities. I think some of those Magic fans can hardly bear to look.
4-10 in this extra time period.
Yeah, one more goal here and it will seal the deal if it's not sealed already.
Anna Hansen steps up.
Foul to construction. That's all.
And short pass. Yeah, it didn't look like too tired. Touched it, which is what George said. Debrain came in with a hand. Leanna Debrain, I tell you what, she was quietish in the first half. In the second half, she has been huge.
Magic fans in full voice.
And I suspect some of the Mystics fans in the crowd and at home will not be able to believe what they're seeing.
Morocco. Stand up and deliver.
She knows why Tamona's in the crowd.
The Magic players had come into this game. They didn't want their 10 consecutive wins to be for nothing. So that's what it would have meant if they didn't win this one.
Williams calling Debrain out. She wants to sit back now because of a foot injury. Smart move.
And Jenny, I've got to say, as a player, when you're this far in front, you know the game is won. You enjoy every minute of it, and it is hell for the opposition.
And I suppose now it is time, perhaps, to think back on the career of Timmy Parra-George. Because it looks like it is going to come to an end tonight in Auckland. Her 75th ANZ Championship. She checks the score. Championship game, I should say. And Irene van Dijk misses. I don't think she's going to care too much. Because the Magic are going to Melbourne.
Yes, the fairy tale, the Magic continues. Who would have thought after four rounds, when they hadn't won a game, they'd be here.
And that's the easiest ball Leanna Debrain's picked up all night.
Still not happy.
What an extraordinary game of netball. And you can only imagine the sort of work that's going to go into Casey Williams' foot or ankle or whatever it is. And a shot from Tutaia. And now Williams really looks in trouble. Still offering, still receiving.
Yeah, she's cramping up now, Williams.
You worry, I guess, exactly what is it. You would hope that she would go off if it was anything more serious.
What a terrific effort by the Magic, though. The Mystics have thrown everything they had at them, and they have come away with a solid win.
So 10 seconds remaining in the career of George. It's not her night tonight. The Magic mission is complete. And they make the 2012 Grand Final. For the Mystics, it is all over. A most unusual game of netball.
A terrific game, a game worthy of a preliminary final. Both teams should be very proud of their efforts. There had to be a loser in the end. The Magic just sustained the pressure. And they regained their composure when they looked gone for all money. And in extra time, they were absolutely unstoppable.
Incredible, Catherine. When you look at those scores, the Magic scored 13 goals in extra time. The Mystics just four.
And as I said, Jenny, it looked like the Mystics were home at the end of normal time. And sometimes you feel deflated when it goes that further 14 minutes. But the Magic should enjoy every minute of this, because it's not long before they face the Vixens now.
Elation, euphoria, sheer joy for this Magic side. And I suspect the Mystics simply cannot believe it. Let's go sideline now to hear from Laura Langman.
Well, Laura, what a spectacular game. It certainly lived up to its expectation.
It certainly did. I mean, man, overtime, and we really stepped up, so really proud of the girls. That fifth gear was awesome.
At the end of regular time, it felt like the last few minutes of the game, it was going the way of the Mystics. Liana Debrain came out and got that amazing intercept.
Yeah, I think we got to that stage, similar to the Thunderbirds. We had to get ball and we had to go for it. And it's amazing when the unit applies that pressure, we'll come up with some. So, great work.
So what was said in that extra time break? Because in that fifth quarter, I mean, you ended up winning by what, 8 goals? 9 goals?
Yeah, we had to go for the ball, go back to our game plan and go to our intentions.
Your legs must be pretty tired, Laws. You were absolutely amazing out there, getting nearly every second ball. But tonight we bid farewell to one amazing mid-quarter. You've played alongside her, you've played against her. She will be missed.
Oh, dearly. And I think I, for one, wouldn't be... I'd be a very happy camper if she decided to come out of retirement. But yeah, Bobby, she's a legend in the game. And we wish her all the best in her new journey. And she's certainly a netball great.
So you face the Vixens next week. You've got one more win left in you, this Magic outfit.
Surely.
All the best, Laws.
Daddy.
And over to you, Ricky.
Where I have to, Putter George, who wouldn't have heard that tribute from Laura Langman, but let's go back into that. You're up by a couple with a couple to play. Where does it slip over for you?
Yeah, I think it's just that... I think that street smart gameplay, which we didn't have in those last 2 minutes. We're up by, I think, four, and they came back, and it's just... Yeah, obviously it wasn't our night, and good on the Magic. Hope they win the final.
What was said in the break when you're going into extra time? What was the message heading into it?
Yeah, pretty much the same. Just, you know, possession ball. We've trained it in training, but obviously it didn't work out there tonight. Bit of a bummer, but at least we got a New Zealand team in the final.
Could you have maybe thrown a bit more caution to the wind in that final period, in that extra time, and played a bit of Mystics ball, a bit of flair, and seen what happened?
That would have been nice. That was our plan heading into it. But Magic are, you know, experienced campaigners, and they've been in the finals for a long time, so I hope they win it.
And obviously, your last game, everyone already saying, can you please come back? We've had it many, many times. I'm sure very hard to sink in at the moment, but what's your emotion at this stage?
Yeah, no, it is definitely my last game. And just like to thank everyone out there, everyone who's supported, not only the Mystics, the Ferns, but myself. So it's been a long, long career. But, yeah, the Kiwi fans are awesome, and just keep it going.
What are you thinking waking up tomorrow morning? I'm no longer a pro netballer.
Don't have to do recovery. Yeah, it'll be different. I think it'll take a wee while to sink in, but I definitely won't miss waking up those early mornings in the cold and going to training. But miss the girls, miss the fans, but I'll be around.
Well, commiserations, get back to your team, and thank you for all you have given to New Zealand Netball.
Thanks very much.
So we see the end of a mighty career as the stadium bids farewell to Tammy Parra-George, but look at the delight on the faces of these two, Debrain and Van Dyke, key players for the Magic. Outstanding tonight, and they have helped their side through to the grand final of 2012 as the Magic.